Hi, my name is Dan. In this video, we're going to be using Illustrator to build UI and web graphics. Okay, there's lots of free stuff here on my channel. Please subscribe, hit the little bell next to the subscribe button to get notifications. If you want more, loads more. Okay, check out bringyourownlaptop.com or check out the link in the description. In this video, we're going to look at making a sitemap. Now, we can do this in a couple of programs. I'm going to show you how to do it in Illustrator, because it's an Illustrator class. But then I'm going to show you why I don't do it in Illustrator, mainly because it takes so long. Okay, so let's quickly look. Oh, first of all, let's talk about how I traditionally do it. Okay, I'll do a sitemap just by hand in my notebook. Okay, now, if I'm dealing with my own site, okay, it's just by hand. That's it. Game over. Okay, I draw it up. Now, if I'm doing it for a client, okay, they're expecting a higher level of presentation, so I will do it in either Illustrator or I'll do it in something called Muse, which I'll show you quickly in a second. But there's no real kind of like tool specifically for it. Okay, so we're going to use Illustrator to get started. So we'll go to File, New, and we'll make probably because it's going to be printed and sent to the client, it's going to be A4, and I will make it landscape. Okay, and I'm going to click Create. If in the US, go letter, okay? And all you do, it's not particularly exciting, okay? It is grab rectangle tool, okay? I'm gonna give my fill either white or no fill, and I'm gonna put a black line around the outside, okay, about that. And in terms of the stroke, I'm gonna set it to 1 pixel. Yours might be set to points still, don't worry, just use 1 point for the moment. We're gonna change that over in a little bit. Okay, so sitemap is to kind of show the client the flow of the website, okay, of where things are going to go, how it's going to be structured. So what you can do is draw out a box, okay, and grab the type tool, and you say, this is your homepage. Okay, and I'm going to center these two together by selecting them both, and up the top here, okay, I've got some options, and there's that one there that says center. Okay, and now I'm going to draw my next page. So I'm going to probably move that over a little bit, and I'm going to copy and paste them. So edit, copy, edit, paste. I'm going to line it up. Okay, and this one here is going to be my, say, my product page, product. Okay, and great. I'm going to tap that over using my keyboard. Okay, next page. And you can kind of see it's a little bit monotonous. It's not too bad. Depends how big the structure needs to be. Okay, so I'm going to go into here, and this is going to be my about us page. Okay, I should probably center this text to make it easier, but you get the idea. Now I need to join these up, okay? And there's a line segment tool here. Yours might be hidden under some of these ones, so click and hold down and grab line segment. And I'm gonna click, hold, and drag. You can see it joins those two up. This one here, it's pretty good at lining things up. If your thing is not lining up, you can see mine's got this lovely intersect and all these, like, see these pink lines jumping everywhere? You can turn that on and off under view. Okay, and there's one called Smart Guides. So have that on at the moment. You can see my one here is not actually drawing a line. You see it left there behind. It's because when I started drawing, can you see I've got no stroke, no fill, and that can catch you out. Okay, so I'm gonna grab my black arrow. I've got them selected still, and I'm gonna say, you, my friend, need a black stroke. And you can see the stroke is the kind of line around the outside. This first one here is the fill. Okay, and because this is a line, it doesn't have a fill. This guy here still exists, okay, but he's got no stroke, no fill, so he doesn't print, so he's not very useful. So I'm gonna turn this guy on. Okay, so that's fine. Now we wanna kind of build this out. So we wanna grab the line segment tool. I'm start drawing this one out. And that's it. There's just a lot of boxes, a lot of copying and pasting, a lot of joining lines to them, making sure they snap. So it's not super hard. But if I'm gonna do a wireframe, I'm probably not gonna build it out this way. I'm gonna jump into something called Muse because it's super easy, okay? And it's part of the Creative Cloud license. So if you've got this latest version here, you'll have Muse. And if you use it, you totally can use Illustrator. Okay, keep going with Illustrator, keep building this thing out. Probably the biggest problem comes, it's not so much building it as when the client will, you know, when we need to change things, we need to kind of move this over here. Okay, and this needs to come as well. So we're selecting all these and this kind of adjustments become a little bit harder. So let's go jump into Muse and why I love it for just doing the wireframing. So download and install Muse. You don't have to, okay. I'm gonna make a new site. Okay, in terms of page width, we're not worried about this at the moment. Okay, we're just gonna click OK. And we're gonna open, or we're just gonna stay here actually. So in Muse, Muse, just so you know, it's a web design program without using any code. And it's really cool, and I've got a course on that if you wanna go and do it. But we're gonna use it just in this case as part of Illustrator process and UI design because of this beautiful plan view. So just make sure you're in plan. you can see here, I've already got a home page, which is handy. Then I can click this little plus button. You can see, hey, okay, I can put in my, say, product page. When I say product page, it's like if we're building a site for widgets, that's where the widgets would go there. Now I'm going to put in my about us page. Okay, you can see how fast this workflow is. Contact us. And then when we go to products, we can say, I would like, say, product, can't spell, product A, you can do it, product A. Okay, and watch this, this is where it's kind of nice. You can see it's kind of done this, joined those lines, got a cool little flow chart going, and it just becomes very easy to build a sitemap. Okay, Okay, you can keep building this out, you can keep adding bits, you can move them. So watch this, say the about us page needs to be there. You can see this switches around, and that's probably why I like it the most. Now, depending on the kind of sitemap you're making, okay, you can do it up here. You can go horizontal, vertical, whatever displays it more clearly for your client or for yourself. Okay, so I'm gonna go back to this, the size. Okay, you can make it big or small to fit in lots of different pieces. And that's it, okay? They're already labeled. They've got nice little lines and flow charts. Now, the question might be, what do I do with it now? And there is no like export PDF of this sitemap, which should be a really cool function in Muse. It's not. All I do is take a screenshot and then add it to InDesign or Illustrator as an image. Okay, so that's my workflow. You might not like this black here. You can do some basic stuff. You can't go through and style the fonts and everything, but you can do some stuff. Say that I wanna put this, I'm gonna go to Adobe Muse at the top and go to Preferences. If you're on a PC, that Preferences is hiding under Edit down the bottom here. Okay, so I'm gonna go to Preferences. And what you can do is switch out the kind of backdrop for this kind of lighter color here. Then you can do a screenshot on a PC. Okay, there is actually a button called screenshot. It's around where your home and end page up buttons are. On a Mac, it's gonna be Command-Shift-4. Okay, Command-Shift-4, and then just click, hold, and drag it out. Okay, I'm gonna take a screenshot. And then what I do is I just open up Illustrator, get rid of you guys, because you take too long, and then I'm gonna go to File, Place. Okay, and find my screenshots, there you are. Put them in there. Okay, and then I kind of design around it. I might put in things like the job name, you know, the client name, this version of the sitemap. Okay, it's quite important. So there's one I kind of made while I was getting ready, sitemap, there you are there. Okay, so I took a screenshot of the black version. I just added my client name, my design agency name. I gave it a version and I put in my logo just to brand it up and give it a bit of, I guess, look and feel for your client that you're delivering it to. Okay, so remember, by hand is perfectly fine when you're dealing with your friends and your buddies and your parents. Okay, I find I don't go further than that, but when there's a paying client, often this kind of expectation or this kind of level at a meeting would be expected. And yeah, you can either use Illustrator, drag boxes, join them up, nothing wrong with that, or you can jump to Muse and just use that cool little tool, take a screenshot, dump it into here. All right, so that is setting up our sitemap for your website design.
How good was that, right? If you want more, go check out bringyourownlaptop.com or check out the link in the description.